Hariharan is a mechanical engineer by profession and is presently pursuing his postdoctoral research in Postec University, South Korea. Prior to this, he was working with the research department of Ashok Leyland, Chennai for around 8 years. He holds a PhD in mechanical engineering from IIT Madras. His hobbies include listening to music, reading books, and writing short stories. He is fond of reading historical fiction. He likes to write about typical South Indian life. He has written close to 25 short stories in his blog, two of which have been published. He hails from Nagarkoil, the southernmost part of India. Jani Rajshekhar. It's called The First Salary. It was a fine Friday evening. The bare earth, cooked in July rain, spread its fragrance fresh into the humid air and diffused itself with the aroma of fried pakora in almost all of the snack stalls overlooking the gutter of the narrow street. The sun had already set when Gopal crossed the street and hurried to reach his apartment. All the way home from office, he was unusually swift, unmindful of the mud splashing over his trousers, punishing his old, torn and mended shoes. Chennai is not the right city for rain. It just gives away. The conglomeration of rotten vegetables, mud, gutter, overflowing drainage, mosquitoes, filth, flooded slums, epidemics. Quite a nightmare month for the corporation officials. Few suffer, and many enjoy the rain. Gopal almost slipped near the market, stamping upon the rotten tomatoes and plantain leaves. Unmindful of the difficulties, he rushed home. As he ascended the stairs, his heartbeat rose, he noticed the pathetic condition of his shoes when he removed them. Thought that he should buy a new pair, but immediately postponed the idea with, "It can go for 2 more months. I shall buy after rainy season." Before he dwelled further on his thoughts, he was joined by his parents and sister beckoning him inside. The joy of the family was ineffable, for it was the first salary day of Gopal, and it definitely deserved the joy and celebration, joined by the heavy rain outside. The celebration included a special sweet from Kaveri, Gopal's mother, and an additional hour of prayer in front of the deities for his long life and good health. Gopal washed his hands, changed into a dhoti, prostrated before the gods caged in wooden frames, and then before his late grandparents, adorning the plaster of the wall in black and white dhoti, and finally before his parents. All the while, he was feverishly holding his salary slip, a mark of achievement, an entry to take the baton later from his father in a never-ending relay race. Kaveri looked at her son with delight. A series of past events since his birth ran before her eyes, and she prayed to God again, with closed eyes, for the everlasting happiness. Subramanian, quite accustomed to his accountant profession for the past 3 decades, adjusted his rims carefully and went through numbers of Gopal's salary slip. "They haven't mentioned the PF account number in the slip," he remarked. Gayatri interrupted with 2 bowls of sweet prepared by Kaveri. "Appa, you can carry up your research with a salary slip later. I can't stand the sight of Kesari anymore. Come on, Gopal, this is for you." The room filled with laughter, and the china clay bowls reserved for VIP guests and special occasions went into the sink after repeated fillings. Gayatri took a spoon and started scratching the edges of the vessels for the leftover Kesari. When all of them assembled in the hall, with joy choking their words, Subramanian said, "I still remember my first salary, ₹400 in an envelope. I never took my hands out of the envelope, fearing pickpockets till I reached home. It was quite a ceremony though. Ah, I forgot something." He excavated a parcel with a cheap polythene wrapper from his office bag, which is a safe deposit of almost everything, from stationery to medicine and even a few marriage invitation cards. "This book on investments is a must read for anyone before his first salary. No one gave me such advice. I learned it myself." But the author, "Oh, come on. Why do you want to bother my son on the very first day? You're anyway there to guide him in these matters. Aren't you spare him to enjoy at least now?" Kaveri intervenes Subramanian. Gopal received the book with great respect. He respected his father, whom he believed knew everything about life. When Subramanian started his career 30 years ago, all he had was a single salary, aged parents, 2 unmarried sisters, and a huge debt to his 5 married sisters. From those humble beginnings, he had fought his way out and now proudly owned a single bedroom apartment, one of his lifetime dreams and achievements. However meager his economic achievements may be, to Gopal, his father is better than Bill Gates or Warren Buffett. He would like to continue his father's legacy of planned living with frugality and contentment. "We should not touch his salary. Except for the repayment of his education loan, we should save everything.
Raghavati Mami has taken a gold chit in GRT Jewelers. I went through the brochure. It's a monthly chit of 2000 rupees and lots of benefits. Similarly, the Sridhar family regularly invests in Sriram chips. They say that we'll get 2 lakhs in 2 years for a payment of approximately 1.6 lakhs. Both will be useful for Gayatri's marriage. What about the plot near Gulbancheri? Can you ask our friends for suggestions? Your salary is hardly sufficient for home loan and other expenses. I forgot. I have to send rupees 101 money order to Nambakkal Anjaneya temple tomorrow. Ravini spoke uninterruptedly with excitement. During dinner, she submitted another proposal for finishing the home loan, supplementing Gopal's salary, and then start savings after a year. She had her 5th revision of financial plan for Gopal's salary when they went to bed. Sunday morning, it was Krishnamurti at the bell. Namaskaram, I was expecting you, Kaveri. 2 coffees. Subramanyam welcomed him in. So Krishnamurti, an LIC insurance agent, lived in the same locality and was known to Subramanyam's family for many years. You may know Krishna. Gopal has started earning, so I thought it's time to take an insurance policy for him. We need to guide him for savings, for till last year he knew only about school and studies. Yes, yes, right decision, I would say. How many children are blessed with a father like you? Krishnamurti continued after a small pause. These days, youngsters earn a lot. Their parents don't care what they do with it, and they spend every money on movies, bikes, and other unnecessary luxuries. They realize their mistakes often late in life. Subramani, you're doing a wise thing, and I should congratulate you for an astute son like Gopal who listens to his parents. Obedient kids are rare these days. Krishnamurti smiled and pleased Gopal, his client, and Subramani, his client's controller, simultaneously. He knew his ways of business, and his skills were anything but talking, but he survived and met his ends in this insurance agent commission. Kaveri's filter coffee diverted Krishnamurti's conversation to her. Kaveri, Amma, it's as if yesterday Gopal was playing cricket in his shorts and today he's a big man and I'm only his humble servant. Kaveri was definitely flabbergasted at this dialogue, which he might have recited 1,000 times to his new young clients with the same emotion, and not once did it fail to make an impact. A visibly pleased Kaveri offered an additional plate of snacks and said, please advise him properly. He's but just a boy. You need to tell this to me, Amma. You know me very well. I don't do this as a business. I do this as a service. To me, the welfare of my clients is the first priority. I would say it's only God's mercy that whoever took a policy with me prospered very soon in front of my very own eyes. You know that Saravanan of Canara Bank, don't you? He took a policy and within 3 years he bought a new house. I am a staunch devotee of Goddess Lakshmi and I pray every day for my clients and better the day. Don't worry. Gopal has a bright future. His face says that he is a blessed man. This was Krishnamurti's trademark dialogue. And everyone, including Kaveri at the present moment, bought his spiritual sincerity for his clients. Never once did it bother anyone why the goddess who granted everything to Krishnamurti's clients hadn't given him anything but an old paisa. Subramani, a man of details, justified his accountant profession by scrupulously going through all the policy details, their benefits, bonus, minimum guarantee, returns, risk analysis, and other details. By the end of coffee, he filtered 3 policies and discussed the technical nuances with Krishnamurti to choose one. Gopal was in awe, watching his father effortlessly analyzing the financial aspects of a policy, and made a mental note that he too will learn these truths soon and keep up his father's hard work. It's true that some of his father's friends called Subramani an idiot hard worker, who with but professional smartness could have gained much more than his cocoon single bedroom apartment. However, he's always the first hero of his son. Gopal was asked to sign the papers by sitting cross-legged in front of the ladies. Of course, Kaveri, an adept in Hindu customs, believed in holy time for any activity, had already checked the calendar and ensured that time was not suitable for such positive endeavors. With every signature, Gopal felt important. And after a few signatures on the aged yellow policy form, Gopal became the owner of an insurance policy, like the infinite paranoid swarmier. The weekend passed gleefully with more varieties of plans on savings, deposits, and Gayatri's marriage. The only purchase Gopal made with his first month's salary was a new lunch bag, which now hung along with Gopal in the morning electric train. As the train crossed St. Thomas Mount, he hardly had a space to stand, yet he noticed an advertisement outside about some gold chit between the crowds and made a mental note to tell his mother that night, which would only complicate her calculations. After the usual morning struggle, tactfully escaping the mudslash from dashing auto rickshaws, filth flying from the brooms of corporation workers, smoke vomited by the city buses, He finally settled down in his cubicle, allowing the air conditioner to absorb his sweat into the humid air, while a senior colleague, Kumar, stopped by. Kumar had been nice to Gopal since his joining. Kumar, having begun his life from a humble background like Gopal, felt a certain responsibility to take care of the new kid. And Gopal too had great respect for him. Such gentle relations make a beautiful looking decorated corporate head of family. And this was one such small family who got up on a Monday morning, empathizing with the raindrop tears trickling down the weeping windows. So Gopal, did you have a party over your first salary? Is everyone happy at home?
Oh yes sir, we had loads of fun.
Gopal was referring to his extra cup of sweet and his insurance policy. Good to hear. Money is always good, but that comes with a responsibility. Spend wisely, kid. Gopal smiled understandingly and with a lot of vanity, explained his financial debut with the insurance policy.
What? You took an insurance policy?
Yes, sir. Krishnamurthy Mama told us that in 10 years we get double the money, and my father is not a novice to be convinced on financial terms. He chose the right policy. And I am glad that I have taken the best investment option from my first salary.
Would have discussed it with me. Which century are you living in? Insurance policies are not investment tools. Young men like you should not depend on conventional instruments like policies and fixed deposits.
Your growth will be much faster than your money ever does. There are stock markets and mutual funds to take advantage of the growing economy. You should not work for your money. Your money should work for you. Kumar ended his sagely advice with a quote from Rich Dad Poor Dad, which I've taken our beliefs to be the technical bible for financial investments.
But shares and all are too much for me. I'm not interested in gambling.
Before he finished, Kumar snapped him shut. What a fool you are, Gopal. And for the next 1 hour, Gopal got a free lesson from Kumar on investments and the equity market. Gopal was mesmerized by Kumar's eloquence in equity market, thrilled by his homepage of ICICI Direct, trading shares on a daily basis. And Gopal didn't fail to acknowledge uncomfortably. There are many things in personal finance which are beyond the reach of his father. That evening was a difficult evening for Gopal at home. At dinner, Gopal opened up.
Pa, Kumar sir was talking to me today. He advised me to invest in equity shares and mutual funds.
What? Let's not get into gambling or hard-earned money. It's not for us. Having responded to Kumar in the same way that morning, Gopal was confident he could convince his father, fresh from the tons of advice and case studies from Kumar.
No, Appa. It's not gambling. It's only a calculated risk.
Kumar sir taught me how to read the Economic Times, understand indicators. Of course, it's difficult, but he guides me. You know, I was stunned when he showed me how to transact shares, and as Gopal continued, Subramani's face shadowed gloomily. Kaveri recognized it in time to interrupt. Gopal, we'll discuss it later. Now eat before the curry gets cold. When did a son ever take his mother's cue?
No, Amma. Even a pessimistic estimate of mutual funds is approximately 15% results,
which he says is double than most fixed deposits. Subramani this time got really irritated. Gopal, you just started earning. Trust the experience of elders. Money gambling is not good for our family. No, Appa. Not talking about day trading, which may be called as gambling. We shall invest in the top 30 companies, and in the long term, it will pay a lot of returns. Subramani, completely uncomfortable, stopped him. Gopal, we should try to create something ourselves, on our own, from the very money we earn hard, however tiny the value of the penny is. There lies the satisfaction of building it on our own, free from the curse of numerous people who lost their money in that stupid game. However humble the achievement of mine may be, it's self-made, and not riding on the success of other businessmen. Equity shares are like a cheap game, paying money to someone whom you don't even know and relying on his business acumen. Celebrate when the market booms, believing that you have made the right choice, and lament when the market collapses. I don't want you to get into that nonsense. This time it was Gopal's turn, especially now that he had a reply for this question from Kumar. Pa, even a fixed deposit is actually similar to shares. In fixed deposits, we give the money to government, who in turn loan it to other businessmen and agriculturists, and the interest accumulated is nothing but the profits earned from those business ventures which we have invested with government banks as mediators. In this case, we analyze and invest directly into the right companies. It's more like fixed deposits in particular companies with dynamic interest. Gopal lurched out the exact words Kumar shared with him during the meeting. Even Kaveri was astonished with Gopal's instantaneous financial intelligence. Gopal continued, Appa,
There's a Fidelity Mutual Fund NFO closing this Friday. Umar sir recommends Rascal. It's been a day since you touched money and you have started advising me. Do you know the hardships I have gone through? Do you ever respect your father's experience and wisdom? Go get lost. Don't believe in some idiot Kumar who may be as nervous as you. Even Subramani was a bit shocked later on his sudden outburst. It was not the subject or the content of the conversation, but a feeling that the young lad, whom he had carefully adorned with his protective wings so far, had started to act smart under the advice of someone outside of the family. He felt betrayed that his son decided to choose Kumar's words over his. Often and mostly always, a father's anger has no rationale on the subject, but such soft emotions that actually kill them. They feel out of place, odd, small, rejected, and the thought of negligence. Realization that their sons have grown up suddenly ahead of them, and guilty in their failure to recognize their son's abilities. But the sons, too young to acknowledge these sentiments on the other hand, feel disdained by their fathers, even for their true, pure, good-intended requests. It's the poor mother of the family who gets caught up in such trauma, lending a shoulder to both the grown-up kids. For both the father and son need to her to truly open up. And yet, she cannot divulge the truth to either, for it affects the balance of the relation. Kaveri was surprised at the unanticipated tumult which arose out of noble intentions from two responsible pillars of the family. She didn't speak much till then. Kaveri, I know how upset you might be. Even I was. But think about this. Within one day, where did he get the guts to speak against the elders? I was sad that I failed to teach him discipline. Where have I missed to teach him manners? Today I feel disastrous and an utter failure. Failed to mold a son's character. Believe his innocence, ruthless. No, please don't hold such deep sentiments. I don't think he criticized you or opposed you. He was just attracted to the new information he got. Even when he told you, he wanted to consult your opinion. But your outburst just wounded him. Who knows what thoughts the poor boy was having? You could have patiently explained. Even I was sad the way you treated him. I know him more than anyone and I swear his innocence. I'm worried how he'll feel about it. Do you know that you haven't scolded him for the past 2 years? No one can beat a woman in chronological memory and process. Even at this moment of despair, Kaveri did not fail to mention when and where Subramani had shouted at Gopal and how she felt insulted when he had shouted at him in front of her cousin. Subramani, like all short-tempered men, yielded quicker than rats. Kaveri, go ahead and have a word with him. Give him some milk, let him sleep properly. No father ever has the guts to apologize to his son. And it is, in a way, good. For every son respects his father, even for their mistakes, and the equilibrium of their relationship may get affected with such transparency and attitude. Kaveri went to her next job to attend to Gopal, who was silently weeping. He'd been rehearsing the evening dialogue several times and failed to reconcile with his father's outburst. Kaveri went to him and her maternal fragrance was just what he needed to wipe his tears. Gopal, she never starts to cry. No, Amma, I came with a lot of anticipation that Appa will appreciate my efforts and really respect Kumar sir. He wants me to succeed and give me good advice. I didn't want to let go of an opportunity due to our ignorance. Was I disrespectful to him? Why does he feel insulted? Didn't I come to him for his approval? After all, I am anxious of Gayatri's marriage expenses and our home loan. Gopal's words melted with his sorrow, expression unclear from the jutting tears. And all Kaveri had to do was patiently comb his head and the miraculous stroke soothed Gopal. And satisfaction that all is not lost and the assurance that here she is for me. The one who lives for me, the one who is more desperate than me for my success. She offered him a glass of milk. Gopal grew shouted him. It's your father only, isn't it? Believe me, he is a noble soul who cares for you more than anyone in the world. He is simply afraid that his son doesn't even take a single wrong step. Do you think he had doubts in your intention? I know him more than anyone does and I can promise that he does too. You have to respect his experience. He may not be able to explain several things as you're too young to comprehend, but he's always worried about you. Kumar may be a nice man, I doubt not. And even your father doesn't disapprove your friendship. He might only be worried that personal finances should not be influenced by others. But Amma, listen, I'm not questioning you. You may be right.
I think father will understand that soon. Now be a good boy. The noble soul of your father is troubled at your rash behavior of talking against him. Go and apologize. Gopal was not reluctant to get up and apologize, for he was more troubled and guilty that he had disturbed the peace and felt sorry that he had spoken against his loving father. He went to him, stopped near the bedroom. Appa, sorry. I didn't intend to upset you. No, don't weep now. Be a good boy and sleep well. We'll talk about this later. Go to the deity and smear the sacred ash on your forehead. Actually, Subramani needed good sleep. The next day, Gopal got up and everything was normal. The kitchen spread noise, the flavor of Kaveri's daily fight with vegetables and spices. Subramani was finishing his newspaper and Gayatri was getting ready for her college, running around looking for lost hairpins, for missing assignment notebook and cursing student life. That's the beauty of family. Hatred, discomfort, or any negative feelings just get wiped away in the first time. Everything was normal. No sign of the previous day's sentiments, except that both Gopal and Subramani vowed internally to correct them. That's why friends are there, to tell you exactly what to do there. Subramani reached his office and read If, the poem by Kipling, a habit he imbibed under difficult situations, much helpful at the time of annual appraisals. His friend came in. What, Subramani? Looking tensed? Subramani was waiting for this and he just blurted out the previous day's incident. Ah, you're a stupid Subramani. I think you should have appreciated your son's responsibility. How quick are kids these days? I promise you, you know nothing of share markets. Encourage him to do some mutual fund and countless. If you're anxious, advise him to invest less and understand economics. The fundamental thing in equity is you need to invest both money and time for it. Cannot sit in office and wait for external enlightenment. Stop behaving like an old bag and go get him that Fidelity mutual fund. Gopal seems wise. I wish we too were like him when we were young. We could have made more. The response was crisp and short, but it pained Subramani's self-ego. He once again went through the poem. He was still not satisfied. He then went through some websites and read mutual funds for dummies. Though not convinced, he decided to trust his son's wisdom and was simultaneously afraid to do so. Finally, he gave up and downloaded the NFO form of the Fidelity Mutual Fund and filled in his son's details. He came home early and placed the filled form within an envelope in front of the puja shelf, hoping to give Gopal a pleasant surprise. That evening, when Gopal went to the puja shelf to place an envelope he brought, he was surprised to see another envelope. He opened the envelope and saw the NFO form filled on his name by his father, except the signature. He smiled and kept another envelope, which had a form filled on his father's name for a fixed deposit in an Indian bank.